summer, some of us kind of got together and we thought it'd be a cool and neat idea for our team to go on a mission trip, or some of the girls who were interested to, you know, go out of the country and do some international work.
I've always wanted to go to Africa, always wanted to do something like that. So I think the opportunity presented itself, and it was a good opportunity to get out, do something different, get out of the boundaries of South Dakota, America in general, and go do something for other people.
We just wanted to go on a trip somewhere, a mission trip, to spread our faith, but also to just help people in need any way that we could.
One thing that stands out to these Jackrabbit ladies is the warmth and kindness portrayed by the residents of Ghana.
All the Ghanaian people are just extremely friendly and just welcoming. People there are very hospitable, very friendly, and very welcoming. You know, right away when we got there, you know, we stood out and people knew we weren't from Africa, but everyone welcomed us and they're really nice and really hospitable.
And right when we got there, I saw a sign that said Akwaba and it said welcome home, and I thought that was cool right away. So that was one of the words that stuck in my head, and everyone was always saying Akwaba, Akwaba, just welcome, and very open arms over there.
Of all the places the Jackrabbits visited while in Ghana, the most impressive was their up-close and personal look at an African rainforest.
You know, you learn about the rainforest when you're younger, but to actually be there and see it firsthand, it's beautiful. I mean, it was one of the highlights of the trip for me. And we walked on a canopy bridge that was 9 stories above ground, and I am not a height person. I am terrified of heights. So that was something, you know, you had to get comfortable with.
The tour guide, one thing that she said right away was, this is 100% safe. And I just thought, this can't be 100% safe, you know.
I love how the lady at the beginning is like, no one has died yet. It was, no one still has died, as I believe, so it's good.
Being up that high in the midst of the jungle and just looking out and just seeing just the view was really awesome. And then it started just pouring on us. Not until we got on the canopy, it started pouring, and then when we got off, it stopped. So it was just kind of a cool experience.
And all four Jacks agree that the trip to Ghana made a significant impact on their lives.
I personally really enjoyed the time with the kids that we got to do, whether it was the basketball clinic that we put on or just going to the orphanages. And also something that stuck out to me was just how helpful everyone is to each other there. We were close before we left, but we were even closer when we came back. And we made a lot of memories and we impacted each other in ways that we'll never forget.
Trying to talk, communicate to more people, and if it doesn't necessarily have to be a spiritual conversation, but just doing something nice for someone, or just being a little bit more relaxed, kind of taking a little bit of their lifestyle back with me here.
They legitimately had nothing and found joy in every day, and were just so happy in what they were doing. Whatever they were doing, they were happy in it. And I've really come to appreciate the things that I don't have. I don't like stress about it or fret. I really just praise for what I do have and thank everyone around me.